Dutch Growers here today to talk to you about some common household plant insects that we all have probably dealt with once or twice or a lot. Today I'm going to talk to you about mealybug and aphids. So both mealybug and aphids are technically called a sap sucker. So they suck the nutrients from your plant leaves, from the phloem cells of your plants. So if you start to notice the early signs of a bug infestation in your household plants, I like to recommend quarantining that plant. So you want to move it away from other plants, especially from really aggressive bugs like your mealybug and aphid, just to help save your other house plants from the stress of potentially being infected with these bugs. So with mealybug, they like to lay their eggs in the soil of your plants during this late summer to fall months. Now is the season between beginning of January to now is when you're going to start seeing those eggs hatching, and then you're going to start running into problems with the mealybug. Now with mealybug, they generally like to favor ornamental plants and succulents. They like to hide in the crevices of your plants, so they favor those succulents. They can hide underneath, especially succulents like echeveria. They tend to hide right under there, so you don't really notice them until they've hatched and have lots of larvae. So that's what makes them a little trickier to get rid of with the mealybug. And once you see the mealybug, they're very distinctive. You're gonna see white oblong little bodies, and they also leave a trail of white, you could say cottony substance, along the crevices of your plants. And that is a big sign that you've got mealybug. Now, commonly mealybugs do like to favor succulents and ornamentals, but they don't discriminate. They will attack all your other types of tropicals if given the chance. Now, the difference with aphids is that they are also a sap sucker. They're also going to suck the sap from the cell walls of your plant. They're going to take the nutrients. They do have a similar body shape. They're about an oblong shape. The only difference with the aphids is that their larvae, they don't coat themselves in a waxy, cottony substance like the mealybug. You will find signs more so of a gall. So when aphids are usually attacking your plant, sometimes you will see a gall. It'll be on the undersides of the leaves generally, and they look like little bumps along your plants or really unusual mounds on the leaves of your plants. So if you are starting to see something similar like an aphid gall, that's a good time to start treating. They generally will take on a yellow in their nymph state, and they'll grow into a deeper green color, and they will cluster on the leaves of your plant. So if you are unsure if you have aphids or mealybugs, it's good to watch out for signs such as wilting in succulents. Your succulents are going to start looking very wrinkly and veiny. In your tropicals, they're going to start wilting. They're not going to grow as healthy. And then again, once you get to that adult stage, you're going to notice the clusters of bugs or the cottony clusters of the mealybug. Once you start to see those signs and you don't have a pesticide near you or on hand to access, I usually like to recommend taking your plants into a warm shower and rinsing them off, really being careful and drying those leaves off to wipe off any excess egg sacs or adults that are living on the surface of the leaves. With the mealybug, they tend to get into those crevices, so sometimes just showering them is not enough. You can take a Q-tip and you can get into those crevices and wipe away those cottony sacs that are along your plant as well. So as you know, mealybugs and aphids can be very aggressive, so sometimes showering off just isn't enough. So I like to recommend insecticidal soaps or an insecticide. So first off, I like to recommend insecticide or soap if you're looking for a safer, more natural option. Your insecticidal soaps are mainly going to consist of fatty acids and salts, mainly potassium salts and other types of acids. And you want to spray your plants with the insecticidal soap about once every week for one treatment, and you really want to just lightly coat the plant. And what the insecticidal soap does is it suffocates larvae and the adults so they can't spread and injure your plant further. And so if you find that the insecticidal soap just isn't strong enough, it's not working, and you're getting those reoccurring problems with your aphid and mealybug, I like to recommend Endol Next. So Endol is a pesticide. It contains pyrethrin, canola oil, and insecticidal soap. It is more aggressive in killing the stages of bugs, especially mealybug. It'll kill the nymphs, it'll kill the eggs, and it also kills the adults. With this one, again, you want to dilute. You want to lightly spray your plants until there is a nice light drip of the Endol coming off of your plants. You can also spray the soil, and you want to repeat that about once a week for 3 to 4 treatments. I really like the Endol because it's more aggressive and it works a little faster and stronger than the insecticidal soaps, especially if you're having those problems with the reoccurring issues of mealybug and aphids. We all know that we don't really want to fertilize our houseplants in winter time, but mealybug, aphids, even spider mites, their eggs tend to hatch in our winter season. So if you find that your plant has been a victim of these household insects, it's really struggling, it's going to want to take some sort of nutrient intake so you can ease the stress on that plant after it's been attacked by a sap-sucking bug like your mealybug or aphid. So I like to recommend the Rage Plus. So what this is a potassium fertilizer. And potassium is really good for your tropical plants, and it's great for the overall health of the plant. So if you do find you have a plant that was attacked by a household insect, or it's just really not doing good and you want to ease the stress of it, you can add this into your watering schedule about every week to 2 weeks, and that'll help carry your plant into the normal fertilizing season, especially if it's been stressed out, if it's been suffering from a bug infestation. And that is it, Plant Fam. Unfortunately, bugs are inevitable. They come hand in hand with your plants. We don't like dealing with them, but here at Dutch Growers, we've got everything you need to help you get rid of them, to control them, and keep your plant healthy and happy. If you have any questions, you can always give us a call in store or visit us at DutchGrowers.com. Have a good day, everyone.